Dinesh, so any of your queries? Today we will start as exercise. Yes, Dhiren.
Sir, please tell about the saltwater lake.
Saltwater lakes are basically lies in a deserts where due to the evaporation, high rate of evaporation, salinity, it remains as the same on a surface. Such salinity has generally occurs due to the accumulation of water. Where the water accumulated for the longer duration through the water logging, the problem of a water logging, salinity increases in soils. And that water which has lies in the same area for a longer duration, they are generally as the origin of a salt water lakes. Example as a Sambhar lake in Rajasthan. Sambhar in Rajasthan, known as the salt water lake. Sambhar, S-A-M-B-H-A-R. Sambhar in Rajasthan. As such, their inclusion, the salt water present on a surface, there are lagoons present. Lagoons generally occur on the coast of the country, where the depressions filled with the saline seawater during high tides. Clear? During high tides. Now exercise. MCQs. In which of the following states? Now I will call here the, some of the names. They have to raise their hands. Aditya Dhiman and Renuka from 9th A. Aditya Dhiman and Renuka from 9th A. From 9th A. Whereas from the 9th C. Manivit Bedi and Harshit Bedi. Yes, Manivit Bedi and Harshit Bedi. Harshit Bedi, raise their hands. So the first answer, in which of the following states is the Vullar Lake located? Aditya.
Which of the following Vullar Lake located? Sir, 1 minute, please.
Sorry? In which of the following states is the Vullar Lake located?
Sir, Jammu and Kashmir, sir.
One more thing. Vullar is an example of a which category of lakes? Vullar is generally known as the which category of lakes?
Sir,
freshwater lake or a tectonic
freshwater lake.
Tectonic lakes. Yes, Jayati. What do you want to ask? Jayati.
Sir, I want to give the answer.
Okay, second answer. Second question is your. The river Narmada has its source at?
Amarkantak.
It's in which state? It's on which state?
Amarkantak. Sir, please.
Amarkantak lies in which state?
Madhya Pradesh.
And then just tell me the name of a dam which has constructed on it. Sardar Sarovar. Very good, Jayati. Sardar Sarovar. So the next second person, Renuka, 9th A, Renuka, Manivit and Harshit Bedi. Raise your hands. So Manivit Bedi. Third question is here. Which one of the following lakes is a salt water lake? Salt water lake. Manivit.
Sir, Sambhar.
It's in which state?
Jammu and Kashmir.
Rajasthan. Next, Harshit Bedi. Which one of the following is the largest river of the peninsula India? Peninsula India. Harshit Bedi.
Godavari.
What is another term, another name has given to this river? Godavari. What is another term? Can you name the any two of the tributaries of Godavari? Two tributaries of Godavari. Ashit. Yes, G. Yes, Janvi. Janvi.
Yes.
Yes, Bachi. Can you give me the names of any of the two of tributaries of Godavari?
Sir, Vardha and Purna.
Sorry?
Sir, Vardha and Purna.
Vardha, Purna, Penganga, Venganga. And what is the another name given to the other name given to the Godavari?
Dakshin Ganga.
Dakshina Ganga. This is as, thank you, very good. Now the next question. Next, as to the, yes, Dhiren Mahajan. Last fifth question. Which one amongst the following rivers flow through a rift valleys? Rift valleys. Rift valleys. Dhiren. Very good. Tapi. So two of the rivers are there which are generally flow through the rift valleys. Narmada and Tapi rivers. Narmada and Tapi rivers. Narmada and Tapi rivers. Clear? So Anshya, what is your query? Anshya Agarwal.
Sir, I wanted to give the answer.
Anshya.
Sir, I wanted to give the answer.
Okay. Question number two, answer the questions briefly. That's your question. First part, what is meant by the water divide? What is meant by the water divide?
A water divide is an elevated area that separates two drainage basins.
Which separates the two drainage basins. Example?
Satpura lies between Tapi and Narmada, and Ambala lies between Satluj and Yamuna.
Very good. Next one. Okay. Vanshika Nagpal, raise your hand from 9th A. Vanshika Nagpal. Vanshika Nagpal from 9th A and Jasleen Khosla. Jasleen Khosla, raise your hands. Raise your hands. Vanshika Nagpal and Jasleen from 9th A. From 9th A.
Yes, good morning, sir.
Good morning. Second question is your. Which is the largest river basin in India?
Which is the?
Largest river basin in India. Question appears on the screens.
Ganga basin.
What is its length? Length?
Length. Sir, I...
2,500 kilometers. Vanshika, wait. But the Brahmaputra having the total length of a 2,900 kilometer. Why we are not called Brahmaputra as the largest river basin? What's the reason? Vanshika?
Yes, sir.
What is the reason we are not called the Brahmaputra as the longest drainage basin in India? Its total length is a 2,900 kilometer, whereas a Ganga is a 2,500 kilometers long. What is the reason? Because Brahmaputra, when it originates in China, it drains, it flows in a long distance in a eastward sides. Then afterwards, the flowing in India, it enters in a Bangladesh. So there 60% of a total surface area, it is lies in other countries. The question is a largest river basin in India. It's as the Ganga, which originates from the Himalayas and fall in Bay of Bengal. 2,500 kilometers long river. Third question is, where do the rivers Indus and Ganga have their origin? Lakshjarat. Lakshjarat. 90.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Answer.
Yes, sir, I want to answer the question.
Yes, answer.
Yes, sir. For which question? Third one or second one?
Third one.
Sir, river Indus originates near the lake Mansarovar in Tibet, and Ganga originates from Gangotri Glacier.
Very good. Indus originates from the Kailash Mountains of Mansarovar. In Mansarovar, whereas Ganga originates from the Garhwal district of Uttarakhand in Kailash or in Himalayas. You can see as a Gangotri Glacier also, directly as a Gangotri Glacier. Next, name the two headstreams of the Ganga. Name the two headstreams. Yes, Jasleen. Jasleen from 9th A. Jasleen from 9th.
Yes, sir. The two headstreams of Ganga are Bhagirathi and Alaknanda. They meet to form the Ganga at Devprayag in Uttarakhand.
In Uttarakhand. Very good. Jasleen, very good. It's next one, Gurupal. Fifth question is your answer it. Why does the Brahmaputra in its Tibetan part have less silt? Silt means sediments, despite a longer course. What is the reason? What is the reason? When Brahmaputra originates in a Mansarovar, it is known as a Sangpo. It is basically having the less sediments, less silt. What is the reason? Brahmaputra having the less silt during its course. What is the reason? Yes, Apran?
Sir, because there the volume of water is less, so the silt that is contained by river is also less. But on the other hand, when it enters India, the volume of water is more and heavy rainfall is there. Therefore, the volume of silt is also increased.
Very good. Due to the, when the Brahmaputra originates in a Mansarovar, it's generally having as the narrow valley and less volume of water. Less volume of water. That's why this river, it consisting the less silt, less sediments. But when this river, it enters in Assam, due to the sudden increase in a volume of water due to high rainfall in Mausanram, this river, it caused to transport the larger silt materials, larger sediments to their course. Clear? Through their course. And those boulders which can't be carried by the Brahmaputra during its course, they deposited by the Brahmaputra at their in course, through which as the braided streams, riverine islands or braided streams, they came into existence. Prabhjot Singh from 9C now. Prabhjot Singh, which two peninsular rivers flow through?
Yes,
Prabhjot Singh. Answer.
Narmada and Tapi.
Very good. Narmada and Tapi are the two of the rivers which are flow through the troughs, through the rift valleys on rocky surfaces. Both the rivers, they fall in a Gulf of Khambat on a coast of Arabian Sea. Next one. State some of the economic benefits of rivers and lakes. Economic benefits, agricultural practices. Agriculture. Rivers gives us the fertile lands for agriculture. Second, regular supply. The supply of water to the rivers and lakes used in industries. Third, rivers are the natural carriages over earth, which are used for or which carrying the materials, domestic and industrial waste discharge from industries. Fourth, rivers or lakes are used for human settlements. Clear? Next, below are given the names of a few of the lakes of India. Group them in categories. Vullar, Dal, Nainital, Bheemtal, Bheemtal. The two categories are the natural and a human. So the Vullar, Dal, Nainital, Bheemtal, Loktak, Loktak, Barapani, Chilika, Sambhar, and Pulikat. All these are the natural lakes. These are of natural lakes. And human lakes, the man-made lakes are Gobind Sagar, E option, J option, Rana Pratap Sagar, Nizam Sagar K, and Nagarjuna Sagar, M. Nagarjuna Sagar, M. These are of the artificial lakes, man-made lakes. Clear? Man-made lakes. Man-made lakes. Devya from 9th A, raise your hand. And Harshita Bedi. Harshita Bedi from 9C. Raise your hand, both of you. Both of them. Yes, raise your hands. Divya from 9A and Harshita Bedi. Yes, Harshita. Next question. Distinguish in between of Himalayan river system and peninsular river system. Peninsular river system. Peninsular river system. First, Himalayan rivers, they are perennial in nature. Himalayan rivers are perennial in nature. Perennial means rivers which are flow throughout the year. Those rivers which are generally flow throughout the year, they are known as perennial rivers. They are known as the perennial rivers. In the other side, peninsular rivers are seasonal in nature. Seasonal in nature because they filled with water during the monsoons. During the monsoons. Today's rainfall, the rain occur in this month, July, in Punjab is a monsoonal rainfall. Monsoonal rainfall. We will discuss this in the next chapter of geography. Yes, Ashita?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Second difference.
Sir, peninsular rivers are seasonal rivers.
Wo to ho gaya. Second reason, second difference between as a Himalayan and peninsular rivers, Himalayan and peninsular rivers, second difference, Himalayan rivers originated from the glaciated parts. Himalayan rivers are glaciated origin. Glaciated origins. Whereas the peninsular rivers are originate from peninsular rivers are generally originates from peninsular rivers are generally originates from plateaus and a source of water is a rain. Source of water is rain. Third. Yes, Manivit, what do you want to say? Manivit Bedi. So the third difference is Himalayan rivers form narrow valleys at their origin, whereas the peninsular rivers form broader valleys. They form the broader valleys. Peninsular rivers form broader valleys. Fourth, Himalayan rivers form deltas all the Himalayan rivers form deltas, deltas, whereas the peninsular rivers form deltas as well as estuaries. They form deltas, eastward flowing rivers form deltas, and westward flowing rivers form estuaries. Estuaries. Then examples: Ganga, Brahmaputra, Yamuna, Gandak, Gandak, Ghaggar, Kosi. These Indus, Satluj, Ravi, Chenab. These are originate from the Himalayas. And peninsular rivers. Peninsular rivers. Peninsular rivers. Krishna, Kaveri, Godavari, Mahanadi, Narmada, Tapi, Mahi, Sabarmati, Luni, except them. Four of the tributaries of Ganga are also originates from peninsular India. These are Chambal, Betwa, Son, and Ken. Son and Ken. These are also originates from the peninsular India. Clear? Example. Yes, Aparan?
Sir, we can also take the point of alluvial soil, that Himalayan rivers brought alluvial soil with them.
Okay. Himalayan rivers, 6 point now. Himalayan rivers brought large quantities of sediments and silt deposited at their valleys, which supports agriculture, whereas a peninsular rivers flow through rocky surfaces, resulted less fertile soils. Clear? Yes, Anshya, you want to add something? Anshya Agarwal?
The first and the second point.
First point, Himalayan rivers are perennial in nature. Peninsular rivers are seasonal in nature, whereas the peninsular rivers are basically glaciated origin, G-L-A-C-I-A-T-E-D, glaciated origin, whereas the peninsular rivers originate from plateau, which consists the source of water from rain, yes, Jasleen?
Sir, I want to add a point that the Himalayan rivers irrigate northern plains, and whereas the peninsular rivers irrigate the Deccan Plateau.
But it can't be distinguished, because both are basically used for the draining areas in a different places. Next, compare the eastward and the westward flowing rivers. Westward flowing rivers. Now the first, westward flowing rivers originates from Central India, whereas the eastward flowing rivers originates from Sahyadris. Second, first is the westward flowing rivers originates from Central India. For example, Narmada and Tapi, whereas the eastward flowing rivers originates from Western Ghats or Sahyadris. Second, westward flowing rivers flowing through They flow through narrow valleys of rocky surfaces. Westward flowing rivers flow through narrow valleys of rocky surfaces, whereas the eastward flowing rivers flow through broader valleys. Westward flowing rivers fall in Arabian Sea, whereas eastward flowing rivers fall in Bay of Bengal. Fourth, westward flowing rivers form estuaries like Narmada and Tapi. Westward flowing rivers form estuaries, whereas eastward flowing rivers form deltas. Now examples. Westward flowing rivers, Narmada, Tapi, Sabarmati, Mahi, Luni are the westward flowing rivers. And eastward flowing rivers are Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Mahanadi, Tungabhadra. These are the eastward flowing rivers. Clear? Now the last question asked, why are the rivers important for the country's economy? So do it yourself, because as the agriculture practices, the role of rivers for navigation, water for irrigation in agriculture, use of river water in industries and settlements. Clear? Rivers are the natural carriages of the materials and passengers. Clear? Do it yourself. Yes, Dhiren? Do it yourself.
Sir, how do rivers give navigation?
Navigation on rivers, there are basically as the through boating, goods are sending towards the port areas. As we discussed, the longest inland waterway is on Ganga River from Allahabad, which is now presently known as Prayagraj, Allahabad to Hugli, H-U-G-L-I, Hugli, longest waterway. So through the transportation on Ganga River, goods from the Uttar Pradesh, these are sending towards the Calcutta port. Then afterwards, goods, these are exporting towards the Southeastern Asian countries. Clear? Calcutta is basically the inland port, because as per situation of Calcutta in interiors, it can't be as utilized if the tides not raised. During the high tides, when the water level increases in a sea level, under such circumstances, ships sail towards the Kolkata port. And during the low tides, it's not possible to sail out the ships. Again, when the high tide occur, under such circumstances, such ships which carrying the material from the Kolkata, they sailed out from the port city. So Kolkata is an example of the inland ports. So you have to attempt the long questions on your notebooks. With the questions, you have to mark one of the map as drainage of India, rivers. all the rivers of India. Map which has marked on a page number 19, figure 3.4. Figure 3.4. Today is a Wednesday. Copies it has to ready till next Wednesday. Till next Wednesday. So the submission of our notebooks last date as the next Wednesday. Clear? 8 days are there to complete this chapter. Yes, Janvi.
Sir, we have to mark all the rivers.
All rivers. All major rivers. For example, Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, and Brahmaputra. Ganga, Yamuna, Indus, and Brahmaputra. Indus and Brahmaputra from the Himalayan region. Whereas from peninsular region, Narmada, Tapi, Krishna, Kaveri, Godavari, and Mahanadi. Clear? 6 of the rivers from peninsular India and 5 rivers, Yamuna, Ganga, Brahmaputra, and Indus. Sorry, 4 rivers from the Himalayan region. On your notebooks. Is that clear? This was our chapter drainage. Any questions related with the chapter? Tomorrow we will start as the next chapter from the economics, second chapter, people as resource. Second chapter of economics, people as resource. People, humans are also considered as a resource because they are productive for country. Humans are a people, they constitute as the assets of country, property of country. Yes, Radhika?
Sir, please repeat the rivers that we have to mark on the map.
Ganga, from Himalayan region, Ganga, Yamuna, Indus. One more addition as a Satluj also. Satluj, Indus, Ganga, Yamuna, and Brahmaputra. Ganga, Yamuna, Satluj, Indus, and Brahmaputra from the Himalayan region. And from peninsular region, Narmada, Tapi, Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari and Mahanadi. Clear? Godavari and Mahanadi. Radhika, clear? Yes, Apran?
Sir, will you please send the revised syllabus of social in our WhatsApp groups?
Okay. So tomorrow we will start this chapter as a people as a resource. People as a resource. I will only send a portion of our geography and economics.